your oven to 180 degrees Celsius. Line two trays with baking paper. You will need 5 to 6 cups of self-raising flour, 1/2 cup of milk, 250 grams of unsalted butter, 3/4 cup of sugar, the zest of 1 orange, 3 eggs, 1/4 cup of sesame seeds, and 2 teaspoons of vanilla sugar. You will also need a mixing bowl, a blender, a spatula for mixing, a zester, measuring cups, a brush, a sieve, a small saucepan, small bowls. Gently melt 250 grams of unsalted butter in a small saucepan. When it's done, put it aside to cool. Sift 5 to 6 cups of self-raising flour into a bowl. Zest the skin of 1 orange into a large mixing bowl. Add 3/4 cup of sugar, add 2 teaspoons of vanilla sugar. Mix well. Add the butter once it is cooled. Mix until the sugar dissolves. Add 1/2 cup of milk. Separate an egg, placing the white into a bowl and the yolk into a smaller bowl. Add 2 whole eggs into the bowl containing the egg white. And whisk together. Start beating the orange zest, sugar, butter, and milk mixture, and gradually add the whisked eggs. Add 1 cup of flour at a time and fold into the mixture. Keep adding flour a little bit at a time and fold it into the mixture. You don't have to use all the flour in the recipe. You know you've added enough flour when the mixture starts pulling away from the sides of the bowl. Gather the mixture into a ball and place into a clean bowl. Add a little milk to the egg yolk and mix together. Now we're ready to prepare the kuluriya. Pinch a walnut-sized amount of dough and roll it into a smooth ball. Roll the ball into a snake about 15 centimeters long and fold it in half and plait it 3 times. Place the kuluriya 2 centimeters apart on the lined baking tray. Brush the egg and milk mixture over each kuluri and sprinkle with sesame seeds. Place the trays in the preheated oven and bake until golden. This will take approximately 15 minutes, but keep an eye on your oven. When golden, remove from the oven and place kuluriya on a rack to cool. This batch makes approximately 60 kuluriya or 4 trays. Enjoy.